Overnight, to save energy, our temperature and blood pressure are low, which makes us sluggish. This means early morning isn't the best time for exercise or complicated mental activities. Mornings are a great time to eat a big meal, as our stomachs are more active and our metabolism more efficient.
Look at that.
Late morning is the best time to do things that require lots of brain power, like writing and planning. For physical exercise, it's late afternoon. Athletes should be faster and stronger than in the morning. Big evening meals aren't a great idea, as our stomachs are slowing down for the night. While we sleep, our bodies repair any damage.
Sticking to a schedule based around the timings of your shift is the way to go. But here's the important bit. You need to be doing this even on your days off.
It's chopping and changing routines that really messes with your clock and your health. Till also suggests night shift workers use eye masks or blackout blinds to block out the light when they're trying to sleep, and wear blue light-blocking glasses on their way home in the morning light, as long as they don't drive.
If you've got jet lag, you can't shift your clock by more than 1 hour a day, but you can use light and the absence of light to shift it as fast as possible in the right direction.
Fly east, and on arrival, you should catch strong daylight in the morning. This will shift your clock earlier and closer to the local time. Go west, it's the opposite. On arrival, get light in the evening to shift your clock later.
Fly more than a few hours, and the timings can vary, but apps and websites will help you calculate the best time to catch the light for wherever you're going to.